Welcome back. We are back with another episode of Satisfactory. Alright, so after the last episode, what happened is at the very end, we were doing all of our research and everything like that. We were kind of getting everything back on track for the research. But then I spent a little bit of time, just like a tiny bit of time, we went ahead and made some improvements to stuff. So we did add a little bit more power, so we do have some power. I believe we're up to, let me come over here and check. We are up to 210 out of 170. That way we can get some things. So what we did is, this is how I'm kind of running the power, just start out with. When we go to different places, we are grabbing wood, throw it in here. Making the regular biomass into solid biomass fuel. And then this is dumping into here. And then we have a splitter that's going into these three and then into these three right here. And it is working good as it's going to get right now. All right. And now we have a couple things going on over here. We're going to go ahead and jump over here. This is what we kind of finished up in the last episode. It would have been nice if I had made a ramp there. But what we have over here, this is our screw facility. All right, so we are making screws. So if we come over here, they are just slowly working into here. And we have screws that we are making. And then over here, I went ahead and I built out. And I don't know how to do it. I know that there is a photo mode and everything like that. I don't know how to use it. Goodness gracious, I cannot for the life of me remember key bindings. Let's see, there's a photo mode, but I don't know how to like zoom in and zoom out of the photo mode. I don't understand. Okay, let's see, photo mode, toggle instructions. Oh, I didn't even see where it said photo mode. Photo mode is P. Okay, so if we hit P. All right, but I still don't know how to like undo it. Okay. All right, anyways, we do have our wire coming in here like that. It is not necessarily optimized yet. I will get there to the optimization. I've got it rolling. They're rolling. I'm making wire and I'm making cable, so that's really all I'm worried about right now, so that way we can continue on. So I do have cable there, I do have wire being made now. More of it's going to be made once I actually like play a little bit more, but I didn't get too far in it. All right, I do need to go check on something real quick. I think I don't know if I could research it now. I don't remember if I finished the research, but I do need to get the Caterium going. Okay, so scan. Oh, we did have the scan drive. Oh,
hard drive analysis.
Wow. Alternative the cast screw to start out with. Oh man, that sucks. It's a good thing, but it's a bad thing. It's a good thing because now we get to use the iron ingots straight into screws. But I literally just built all of that stuff. So we're gonna have to go back in there and rebuild all of that. After this episode, we won't build it during the episode. All right, for the Caterium, I think, yes, I did go grab some Caterium. I did make some bars, and so what we're going to go ahead and do is finish that up right there. All right, and then we need 100
research completed
wire to make that right there. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and add that to the list as well. Let's see what else we got going on here. I keep forgetting everything. All right. And then let's go ahead and see what we are going to work on during this episode. I think we have finished all these ones. Let's go ahead and let's work on getting the new logistics right here. So that way I can at least get the MK2s. All right. So let's see what we need to work on. We need to work on... let's see, we should have bars, or we should have that, we should have plates. Alright, so we just have to work on getting the reinforced plates all made up. But I do want to come over here with the Caterium and go ahead and get the wire all queued up and everything like that. I have been having fun. It is nice kind of starting all over, and you, every time you seem to start over, you always have that new knowledge of, you know, from your last playthrough. And so it makes it a little bit easier, so that way, you know, the math starts mathing a little bit better on the, you know, on consecutive playthroughs and everything like that. And with 1.0, they did change a lot of stuff. So there's a lot of stuff that is new at the same time. And so I actually kind of really like that there's some of the stuff is new, and they've kind of changed a couple of the, I would say, the quality of life things. All right, so when we were last over here, we could actually not do anything right over here. The reason why we couldn't do anything is because we didn't actually have the oh, these are supposed to be smelters. Well, no, they smelted. Okay, never mind. This is supposed to be quick wire. All right, so let's go ahead and math real quick. I think caterium is always an off number, so it's 120. But then each one of these is 45, so that's 45, 90. And then I think we are, I just can't even think about it like that. Okay, let's see, 45 times 3 is 135. So yes, we need to underclock one of these, but we don't have the clocking yet. It'll be fine for right this second. All right, but then we have, I think it's 15, 15, 15, so it's 45 bars. And so 45 bars, so yeah, we'll be okay. I think we actually need to build another one too. So let's go ahead and build this. Oh, we're missing cable. Of course we are. I didn't even grab any cable, but we have this over here, so we'll just go ahead and make a little bit of cable real quick. All right, and it's going to be really nice once we open up this next upgrade for the Caterium, because the wire upgrade, not the wire, but the power pole upgrade is probably one of the more helpful things to start out with. I'm not saying that it's one of the things we should do at the beginning of the game, but like, it probably wouldn't hurt to try to get that knocked out as soon as possible, so when you build your giant facilities and everything like that, then you can go ahead and just get them started. All right, so let's go ahead and this is going to be there. Why did it do that? Okay, sometimes I don't know why the stuff does not like to line up. There we go. All right, here to here. Here to here, this is going to be quick wire as well. I don't think we have any power poles right here. Let's see, where did my power poles go? There's one right there, so let's go ahead and bring it over into this area. Right there and there. Okay. Alright, then we're going to expand this just a little bit right here. Ooh, gotta turn on zoop mode. If you do turn on zoop mode, that's R button, just in case you didn't know that. Okay, and we're going to zoop that open. And then we are going to... This is going to be a merger. We're going to move it over this way. Go. All right, and this is going to give us our quick wire that we need. People want to call it smart wire. I know it's not smart wire, but I don't know why I have it always in my head that I want to call it smart wire. I have absolutely no, couldn't tell you why. All right, and then we're going to go ahead and hook this up right here. All right, and then we will have the smart wire going in there. I see smart wire. No, it's quick wire. All right. And then I'm not sure if I want to bring it back to the base. I might bring it somewhere a little bit closer, because it's going to, I'm going to have to end up running up here every single time. So we might go ahead and start some little spaghetti going on here. All right. Let's see. Let's go ahead and run it back this way. I know we're starting. We're starting early. We're starting early. All right. And I think I don't have enough plates. Yeah, I'm gonna run out of plates right here. Okay, let's go grab ourselves some plates and everything like that. Can I even make this storage? Nope, I cannot. Okay, but we're gonna run it back over towards, like, just over here. That way I have the ability to just go across this bridge, grab what I need as we're working. Alright. I know that I'm gonna have to find quartz pretty soon. And I'm not sure, like, starting in this area, it's not that it's a problem, but it's, if you don't know this area very well, then you don't know exactly where stuff spawns, so to speak. So, like, I'm actually unsure on where some of this stuff is gonna spawn. Alright, let's grab ourselves some rods right there. Okay. Alrighty, so we're gonna run back over this way. I'm gonna go ahead and put a little spot so that way I can get this where I need it to be, so that way I can just kind of come over here and click on it and everything will be alright. So let's put it in like these two blocks right here. Alright, and then we're gonna go ahead and build ourselves a storage container. Face this way, there we go. Alright, and then like, oh my goodness, Chip, you're already embracing the spaghetti. Absolutely. Absolutely. I'm all about making sure that we're gonna get some, get our stuff, you know, already kind of. I want to bring everything into one place. There we go. There we go. Alright, so that's gonna bring that down here. I'm gonna wait a second while it does that. I need to go ahead and get some reinforced plates going. I know that I probably should have got the assembler going first, but unfortunately that's not going to be the case. But what's going to be really nice though is for the, where is it at, for this new recipe that we got with the hard drive, I get to delete a lot of constructors. We will actually kind of simplify it, and we get to get rid of the actual rod portion of it. And so that's where we're saving power and saving time, but not converting everything to rods first. Let's see. All right, so I need to go ahead and I need a lot of reinforced plates. What do we need for that? We need screws. All right, so let's go grab ourselves some plates. There we go, plates, and we'll go ahead and grab our screws. Alright. So we did kind of build this right here. Let's go ahead and ramp up right there. And that'll work. Alright, so with all the rods that we're making, we're actually going to be able to delete the rods, but this is not something we're going to do in this specific one, because I still have to go over here and make everything on this side as well. This is only running half of what I wanted to run. So we're bringing in 120, but we are only smelting 60 of it. So we are producing a lot, and we're producing what we want and what we need, but we are gonna make it better after this episode. So when we come back from after this episode, everything's going to look a lot nicer. We're going to see a lot of screws. I mean, heck, we're already building a lot of screws right now, but we're going to see even more screws. All right, and let's go ahead and grab some of this cable, because I know I'm going to need some of this cable. There we go. Oh, I actually need a lot of cable for, it looks like, for one of the, I'm actually not sure which one it is. Says I need protein and cables for a specific one. So what was that under? Let's see. Alien megafauna? Okay, yes, I was going to get some more inventory slots right there. Okay. Yeah, so that makes sense. All right, and then there's the rebar gun down there. So we'll end up getting that in a little bit. Not like this specific episode. All right, so let's go ahead and make ourselves some reinforced plates. That way we can finish up this milestone right here. And then after this one, we'll go ahead and work on getting the assembler all assembled up and everything like that. So that way we can start making those reinforced plates, because we're going to need a lot of them. Once it comes to MK2 belts, the MK2 belts actually take the reinforced iron plates. So we are going to need a lot, and I mean a lot more of them. All right, so we're at 50. 50, we'll get this at least finished right here. Let's go ahead and unlock that. There we go. Let's go ahead and make a few more desks. That way we have a little bit in stock. Contractual obligation towards efficiency. Recreational use of belts and lifts does not count towards work hours and will put you on the list. Stay efficient. Don't stay efficient. Fix it. All right. There we go. Okay. And then we're going to need to do parts assembly. This will open up rotors, module frames, copper sheets. We'll need the spark plating for, I believe, the space elevator. All right. So, all right. Will not let us add anything right now, but we should actually have everything. We should have everything ready to go for this one. Let me go grab another stack of rods. I think they're right here. Nope, just kidding. All right. But we are going to need to redo the metal plates. Metal plates, we're going to have to produce a lot of metal plates, because we need the metal plates and the screws to be all combined and everything like that. So that way we can get that going. Let's see right here. I don't think we're as efficient as we could be on this. I think there's a lot of backups right now. Let me see. All right. Yes. So right now we do have a lot backing up. Honestly, I think it is just the lines. They're not moving fast enough. So if we go that way, and then how do I change it? I can't remember. Quick switch. Oh, there we go. So if we make that into tier 2, they'll move a lot faster. Alright, so this is what we're going to have to end up doing, is we're going to have to end up trying to build these into tier 2. That way they will move faster into the machine. Alright. Alright, and then now we're missing a bunch of reinforced plates and everything like that. But that should move it a little bit faster. They will start moving into the machine faster, because we should be making an adequate amount. Alright. I'm sure there is a better way to do this. I don't remember how I had everything set up on the last one. But we are producing a lot of bars, so they will eventually start, you know, teetering down to the other ones, and they will fill up the other ones. It just does take a moment to do so. Okay. All right, so that should be getting our cable. We need a cable for that. Grab another set of cables. There we go. And the power has been really good. I haven't really had to deal with the power too much and everything like that. It's been pretty self-sufficient now. You know, starting out, it's not. But then now it actually is. Now it's like, oh, okay, now I can actually, you know, be able to move around the whole area and everything like that and not have any issues. All right, we're just waiting for this pod to come back. Once this pod comes back, then we'll be able to build our assemblers and everything like that. But I think there is going to be an issue with the assembler, is because we don't have the right plate production right now. And so since we do not have the right plate production, we're not going to have the right production for the screws. All right, so what we're actually going to do real quick is we're going to change this one over to iron rods. Okay. The reason why I'm going to do that is I want to build this one a lot closer. All right. Let's go ahead and move some of this stuff out of the way. All right. Okay, so that can be destroyed. We don't need that right there. All right. Bars, we don't need it. We'll end up rebuilding everything. All right, there we go. Let's see what we got there. More bars. More bars. All right, let's see. That's rods. And then we have some rods over here. All right. Let's see. I do have... Okay, I have too many things in my inventory right now. Don't need that. I don't need this. I don't need that. Let me go get this smart wiring though. The quick wire, not smart, quick. That way I can finish this this thing so I can get the upgraded poles, so that way when I rebuild this whole area or whatever, I'm able to, you know, effectively. Look at that. Oh, it's so beautiful. I can effectively get all of my power where I needed to get and everything like that. And it sucks that I just built the screw factory in the last episode, and now I need to rebuild it because of the alternate recipe. But it's nice to get that recipe. If you can get that recipe early on in the game, then you're kind of, I'm not saying you're set for the game, but you do have, like, it's really nice to get that ready. Okay, part assembler, let's go ahead and launch that. That gives us the assembler, copper sheets, rotor, modular frames. So these things right here, as such as the rotor and the modular frame, those do have to be put together in the assembler. All right, so we're going to go ahead and open this up right here. All right. And we need these power poles right here. Oh, we're missing some. All right, so we're just going to let that run for like 2 seconds. All right, and then let's go ahead and get this all ready to go. All right, so we are going to be making a plate factory right here.
New Caterium research options available. Congratulations on
Congratulations.
Finding
this metal.
Okay. Many fix-it initiatives will benefit from Caterium's applicability in advanced engineering.
Alright.
It is probably not sentient, and so unlikely to feel pain as we exploit it.
Alright, pain is no gain. Alright, so you are producing 120. So 120 into iron bars. I believe iron bars are 30, so let me just double check. So it's 30 per, so 120 divided by, divided by 4 is, 30 is going to be 4. Okay, so I need 4 smelters. All right, so let's get over here. All right, and then we're going to go ahead and split this. I don't know why it doesn't ever want to put it like right where you want it to. That way it'll actually look nice. Alright, so then it's going to come over here and split one more time. Okay, and then we need 4 smelters. There's a smelter. Smelter. Right. Here to here. Okay. Alright, 4 smelters. Let me go get this smart wire real quick. Go ahead and build that out that way. Let me get the smart wire because I'm gonna need to break down that pole, and if I break down that pole, it's gonna shut the power off. So we're going to get around that pole. I don't need this pole right here. Don't need that power line right there. And I'd really like to, but I don't think it's going to be like anytime soon, unless I just get like a wild hair of trying to go find some of the SAM ore. But I want to find like the SAM ore so that way I can start working on the new stuff. I'm really curious on the alien technology. I've heard that there's some new stuff that was opened up, but I haven't seen any of the new stuff. Haven't really watched anybody. I just don't want it to ruin it for myself. All right, so now we're gonna go ahead and build these power poles right here. All right, now we have the upgraded power poles, which is amazing. Okay. Power pole mark 2 unlocked. So what we're gonna do is we're actually gonna come down here and put that on 8. Power pole mark 1. And then we're gonna put this on 1. Okay. So now we have power pole mark 2s. Go. Mark 2. I'm going to put this right here in the middle. And this one is going to... Alright. And now we're going to get rid of this one. Okay. And we're going to bring this one all the way to the back. Right here. And I love the power pole Mark IIs are so great. Because on the normal ones, the normal... power poles are one, they have 4 spots. These right here have 7 spots, so we're already going to be like ahead of the game and being able to make a lot more things, because now I can just plug that in, I can plug that, I can plug this in, I can plug that one in, and I can plug this one in, and then those will work on the other ones. All right, so we're going to do iron, we're going to control C, and then we just open it up, control V. Control V. And last one, control V. Okay. All right. And these are going to be 30 per minute. All right. Okay. So that gives us, let's see, 30 per minute, 30 per minute. Okay. 30, 60, 90, 120. Okay. So we have 120. And then go ahead and expand this a little bit more. All right, freighter is back. Okay. And then, all right, we're going to want to make just iron plates. This is going to be nothing but iron plates, okay? So to make iron plates, we're going to just, oh, it's going to be just 30, 30, and 30. Okay. So I think I'll just have them just straight up connect to them. Because these are going to be making 30. So make it 30. Right? Yeah. Okay, so each one of these is going to take 30. So we'll just kind of... go there to there, there to there, there to there, and there to there. Okay. All right, and so we're just gonna go ahead and iron plate them all up. There we go, iron plates, iron plates. Here we go. Come over here. Maybe 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, where are we at right now? We are. Max consumption is 193. Our capacity is 210. So we are going to have to make some more power and production. All right. Let's see what we got in here. Take all those. All right. And then we're going to. Right here. A little bit more. And then let's go ahead and get ourselves like a little bit of a ramp that way we can just run up here. Okay. All right, and then I want him to face this way. So what we're gonna do is let's go ahead and do a merger this way. Love it. Alright, and then go ahead and build this off right there. And then alright, and then a storage box right here. Comes out here, and that's gonna be our iron plates right there. Okay. So the iron plates will get all fed there. We'll have to end up remaking that. It looks like we're going to need another power area. So what we can do now is now we come over here and we upgrade our power poles. That way we can add more power to these power areas. My goodness. Okay. Looks like a mess. Just because it is a mess. Okay. So this is building. This is right here. Got that. I guess what I can do is I can add a section over here to come off of that one. That might work in our favor. Let's get a, let's see, some biomass. Oh, we're missing our iron plates. Okay, let's go ahead and grab those. How are we doing on wood? The wood is fine so far. All right, making some plates. Now, of course, whenever we get the reinforced plates, we'll be able to speed everything up. Everything will work a lot faster. I know it's just because right now we've got the slowest, and I mean the slowest things of the bunch. Okay, so what we're going to do is one right here. One right about there. And see if I can get one to be right there will work. All right, and then all right, we're gonna have our splitter right here. This goes to here, that goes to there, that goes to there, this goes to there. All right, and then now we have three spots on here. 1, 2, and 3. There we go. Alright, so that's going to funnel out here. It's going to start producing power over here. This is just temporary. Till we get coal power and everything like that, this is what we're going to have to deal with. But our capacity is up to 300 now. So we're consuming 193. Our capacity is up to 300. So I'm liking it. We're making progress. That's the point of the game, is to make progress. Let's see. Alright, so we need to go ahead and I'm going to finish this specific research real quick. That way we can get these extra slots. Oop, I totally messed up on some power over here. Let's see that power pole. There we go. And of course, as we continue on everything like that, I will rebuild this to get our iron rods and everything like that, but as we go I'm gonna just kind of wing it during the recordings and everything like that, and I will fix everything off stream. Okay, let's see, I needed some of those. Okay, it was under alien megafauna, I believe. Yes, right there. So we're gonna go ahead and give ourselves 6 more inventory slots. There we go.
We are all doing
our... All right, and then that's going to take steel. Is that steel beams? Is that what they're called? Yes, yeah, steel beams. All right, is there anything else that I can work on? Zip lines. I never used the zip lines, so I honestly don't know how those work. That's something that we're going to have to look at in the near future. The smart splitters are very handy. We'll end up getting those pretty soon. Let's see, anything in the mycelia. Let's see, medicinal properties, there we go. Gas mask will be needed in the future. Equipment slot, that would not be too bad, but we need to make rotors. Okay. Alright, so while we're here, I guess, you know, since we are recording and everything like that, I guess we can go ahead and kind of fix our screw problem. That way we can go ahead and get our assembler up and going, because I would like to go ahead and start assembling. So that probably wouldn't be a bad idea to go ahead and get that going, but unfortunately I'm going to have to kind of move some stuff around here. So what we're going to do is kind of, there's going to be a lot of stuff just hanging around and sitting around for a minute. All right, screws, screws, more screws. All right. All right, because we're not going to need any more rods anymore. So since we're not using rods, we're just going to go ahead and cancel the recipe. I forget how to cancel recipes. I think it was just select recipe. Okay. But we're going to go ahead and do the alternate cast screw. There we go. Alternate cast screw to start out with. This is just going to kind of get us going. Let's see. Let me go ahead and... Oh, there's a crate right there. It's in the way. All right, Control C. Control V. All right. All right. And then we're going to have to kind of see where everything's sitting to, because I know we're going to have a different production rate now. Alrighty. There's just rods and bars and everything over. Okay. Alright, so this is just rods. That's no big deal. I'll just go ahead and delete them. We'll get them out of the way. This is bars, that's fine. Rods. Bars. Okay. Alrighty. So we have 30 and 30. That's 60. So we are making 60 right now. Alright, so we're making 60 bars. And each one of these is 12.5. So 12.5 times 4 is 50. Okay, so these two running this is going to be perfectly fine. All right, let's go ahead and get this other one up and running. That way we're not, you know, we're making it. Okay. How do we do this one? Oh, we put this one a little bit further over here because we wanted to go ahead and put... One. Did I put the wrong way? I sure did. Okay. So, one, two. All right. Three. And four. Okay. Go. So we are going to build another one of these guys right here. Right here to here. Go ahead and upgrade our power poles as well. That way we have adequate power. Okay, so why was this not powered? Oh, was it not plugged in? Of course it's not plugged in. All right. this one to there. Nope. Oh, I didn't select it. That's why. Okay, iron. There we go. Alright, so that has power. That has power. Alright, you are coming out of there and feeding into these two. So. I don't think this is going to work in my favor. But it is not. Can I do it off of this one? Nope. Okay. So that's where our problem is going to be. Let's see. Is there any way we can get around this? All right. We're going to have to just go ahead and move this down this way. Right this way. There's a little bit of space. All right. Okay. All right, and then we're gonna move this one over. Here and a splitter here. All right, there we go. We should be somewhat in the right direction, and of course it's not in the right spot. It never is. Okay. I love it whenever you're like, you hit the control button and it's supposed to align up with it and everything like that. It's supposed to put it where it's supposed to be, but then you go back and then it doesn't actually put it there, and then you're just upset because you're like, why didn't it do it? Okay. And select iron ingots. There we go. All right, so we should have a lot more bars than there is like screws and everything like that, so should be golden. All right, and then I think what we're gonna do, I'm trying to figure out, I think I'm gonna bring the plates over here, and so we're gonna get an assembler going and everything like that. We are going to need rotors. Oh goodness, forget how do we construct rotors. Let me go ahead and Rotors. I don't think I can construct rotors, right? No, I'm gonna have to go construct them myself, because I think you have to construct them in the assembler itself. Okay. Alright, so go ahead and make sure that these are running. Go. Alright. So we have them all queued up and everything like that. How are we looking? We're at 210 out of 300. Okay, so we're about the same. So we actually deleted some stuff and we're looking about the same. All right, we needed, let's see, for the assembler, we needed, I'm gonna get two assemblers going. So we need reinforced plates as well as some rotors. Okay, I can't remember what the rotors were. Let me make these real quick. The plates that we need right there. All right, and let me put up some of this stuff. I don't need that. I don't need the mycelium on me. I don't need the copper plates on me. I don't need those. I don't need the bars on me. All right, I don't need 100,000 rods on me. I'll go put those in the chest in a second. All right, let's see. Rotors. Okay, rotors was rods and screws. Okay. Rods and screws. Okay. Unfortunately, I'm gonna have to. You have to build a assembler before you can get these going, unless you're gonna build them all by hand. But we'll be able to build an assembler for that as well. We'll have to go ahead and re-up our rod farm. When we re-up the rod farm and everything like that, we might actually have enough to go ahead and make rotors on just one factory rather than combining them. But we will see. We will see. All right. So that should be enough right there. All right. So this is something that we're going to have to look at real quick too. So we got 20. All right. Something is moving kind of slow over here. I think they're just, it's moving slow. All right. Let's see. Okay. I think this in general is just moving a little slow and everything like that. All right. So we have 20 times 4. So 20 times 4. So we are making 80 plates. And I think this is full efficiency as well. Like, as efficient as we can make it right now. This thing is just taking forever. I mean, we'll have to upgrade this stuff. That's fine. All right. But we are making 80. Was it 80 plates? Okay, so we're making 80 plates. Go ahead and grab some of these plates right here. Go ahead and put all these rods in here. I don't need all these rods. Oh, there's a bunch of plates in there too, so I gotta remember that too. All right, do not need 200 rods or 2 billion rods. There we go. Okay, so we have 80 plates coming out per minute. And then we want to not fall on the ground. Pay attention. All right. But we want an assembler going. All right. So if we pull the assembler going from, if we pull something this way, let me just see what it's going to entail. All right. So to make a reinforced plate, we need, so we're going to, we make 80. So it looks like we might be able to feed two of these with the iron plates. And then with the screws, we are making 50. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right. And then we're making 50 times 8. So we're making 400 screws. Oh, yeah. Oh yeah, so we'll definitely be able to, I'll be able to run two of these guys. So what we're going to do is go ahead and get rid of these real quick. All right, so we are going to have a storage container that is going to be feeding. This is going to be our metal plates. All right, and then we want two of these. All right. So we're going to have screws coming in. All right. And then this is how I want the screws to come in. All right. Because we didn't build stuff like this whenever we first started the last time, right? We were like, oh, you know what? We just kind of, you know, winged it and everything like that. So now that we know exactly what we're doing, so what we're going to do is we are going to have a splitter right here. So this is going to come in right there, and then I want a splitter to match up with that one. All right. Maybe. Are you going to match up? There we go. Okay. So this is going to be our metal plates that enter in. All right. Metal plates go into here. All right. They'll come back up here, come in here. All right, metal plates, that's going to be, we'll have more than enough, that's fine. Now let's go ahead and upgrade this guy too. Here and here. All right, and then we're gonna have our screws. Our screws are gonna come in from... How are we gonna do this? I think I'm just gonna run them down like this. All right, let's see. I want a splitter. I'm gonna try something out. I think I screwed up. Okay, hold on, I screwed up. Yeah, because these are not going to be able to, okay. Okay. So this one's fine. Okay. Yeah, so this one too, this one is completely fine. Alright, so we're going to come to the next one. And we want this one to be merged. It's going to be merged as well. Merger. We're going to do a split on this one. Actually, yeah, that's fine. It's gonna be like right about here. All right. And what I want over here, and I guess I did not put this on the hot bar. We want to go ahead and put our lifts right here. All right, we gotta go down to MK1. Go. And then we want splitter here. Come on. Here. Okay. That's gonna be our screws right there. All right, so what we're gonna do is get that screw from here, so there to there, there to there, here, 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 here. Okay. I feel like the UI for the what are these things called? The UI for the conveyor belts are acting a lot better than I have seen beforehand. All right, so those should be going in there. Those should be getting those loaded up. Now we're making reinforced iron plates. All right, go ahead and get this all done up as well. This one down here. And then let's go ahead and make our torch container. Okay. All right, and then let's bring our plates up this way. Embrace the spaghetti. See, look at them. Look at how they're like, it's wanting to automatically make the 90 and everything. Oh, build mode straight. There's a build mode. Hold on a second. Oh, okay. So you can actually change the build mode. So if you do straight, it's going to, you know, go whichever way. But if you do the regular mode, it'll kind of move wherever you want. If you do the straight build mode, it'll kind of build it more in a factory pattern. I guess that makes, does that make sense? Factory pattern? There. All right. A little bit better. All right. Now we are going to, we're already starting the spaghetti. It's already, you know, episode 3 or 4 and we've already got the spaghetti going. What more could we want? But anyways, I do appreciate everybody coming in. I know that took a little bit of time and everything like that. We are going to have to reassess some things on this build and everything like that. We're gonna get everything up to speed. What I mean by that is by the time we get into the next episode and everything like that, I'm gonna go ahead and upgrade all the conveyor belts and everything like that, that get that all done up and everything like that. We are now automating reinforced plates, which is really nice. So it's probably gonna take a little bit of time to have all the reinforced plates to be able to do this, but it'll be definitely worth it in the end. But I do appreciate everybody coming in. You guys are absolutely amazing. Thank you so much for coming back in here and watching, and I hope you guys have fun, and I will see you guys on the next one. Bye.